This is my all-around, all-purpose Hailey build. Hailey is one of the best descendants in the game, and I have to say, she is one of the most fun to play with. Hailey is also my go-to descendants for any content in the game. She is incredibly reliable and pretty strong. This build is centered around increasing firearm critical hit rate and having high survivability. This build can be used for any endgame content, from invasion missions, 400% invasion missions, and void intercept battles. You can also use this build to solo any endgame content in the game if you want, and it only cost me 9 crystallization catalysts, which is so worth it. Let's start with the reactor. I'm using a frozen mechanics reactor with the following weapon implants: Greg's Reversed Fate, Thunder Cage, and Enduring Legacy Mounting. For the stats, prioritize scale cost because this is the most important stat that will help you with the MP consumption. For the second stat, go for cooldown. For the external components, let's start with the auxiliary power. Prioritize double max HP, and for the last stat, you can go for module drop rate increase modifier or fire resistance if you are fighting a fire colossus. For the sensor, prioritize defense and max MP, and for the last stat, you can go for consumable drop rate increase modifier, character XP gain modifier for leveling a descendant, and chill resistance if you are fighting a frost type colossus. For the memory, prioritize double defense, and for the last stat, you can go for gold drop rate increase modifier, firearm proficiency if you are leveling a weapon, and electric resistance if you are fighting an electric type colossus. Lastly, for the processor, prioritize max HP, and for the remaining stats, you can go for equipment drop rate increase modifier and toxin resistance if you are fighting a toxic type colossus. For the modules, let's start with the sub-module. Go for mid-air maneuvering. This sub-module is the best grappling hook in the game. This provides you the ability to escape any situation and reposition without relying on the terrain. Now, this is my own personal preference and you can choose any grappling hook module. But in my experience, I have to say that mid-air maneuvering is the best sub-module because you can grapple anywhere. For the HP modules, go for HP amplification and increased HP, increasing max HP by 445%. This will also reduce the total shield by 36%, but for me, shields are practically useless because it doesn't benefit from any defense and elemental resistance. For the defense module, go for shield conversion and increased defense, increasing defense by 327%, but at the same time reducing max shield by another 36%, totaling to 73% shield reduction. This build relies on maintaining Cold Fury, which increases the firearm critical hit rate by 2.5% per stack. To lower the MP cost of this skill, go for Maximize Conservation and Strong Mentality, which lowers the skill cost by minus 50%. I also added Enlightenment, which increases max MP by 15%. If you have a sensor with a MP stat, most likely you are going to end up with 500 plus max MP, which is more than enough to sustain Cold Fury for long gunfights. To recover HP, go for HP Collector. This module will keep you alive as long as there are enemies around. HP Collector is a very nice module for keeping yourself alive in any situation. Now, in boss fights or Colossus boss fights, whenever you are low, you can always run away and line of sight and wait for the adds to show up. Eliminating the small adds will heal you up. This module makes me very comfortable knowing that as long as there are adds, I can always heal up and keep my HP bar healthy. This also makes any descendant not to rely on HP drops. Now, I know that the heal is not that much, but it is more than enough to keep me alive and avoid getting knocked down. For the last two sockets, you can go for auto immunity, which reduces incoming damage by 10%, and shot focus, which increases firearm attack by 15%. You can also choose to replace auto immunity or shot focus depending on what content you are doing. In my case, if I'm doing 400% invasion missions, I usually use auto immunity and shot focus. But for void intercept battles, I usually replace shot focus with hit release, perfect anti-venom, anti-freeze solution, or insulated conductor depending on the Colossus that I'm fighting. These modules will prevent any damage over time, which actually deals more damage than the initial attack. This also prevents you from getting frozen in place. You can also replace shot focus with MP conversion, which will reduce skill cooldown by -36%, and use the transcendent module cryogenic cluster shot, which will help clear the mobs in 400% invasion missions or any infiltration operations. But when it comes to void intercept battle, you have to use the elemental immunity modules as it provides you with more survivability. For the inversion reinforcement, go for biodensity augmentation, which increases max HP by 9.5% every time you defeat an enemy, and this can go up to 5 stacks for 30 seconds. Selective neurostimulation gives you a 60, 30, and 10% chance to recover MP every 60 seconds. And lastly, you can go for the survival road depending on the content that you are doing. So go for void adrenaline for void intercept battle, secondary quantization when you are fighting against Legion of Immortality, Biostructure Decomposer if you are fighting against Order of Truth, and Disable Dark Protocols if you are fighting against Legion of Darkness. You can also go for RK Pacemaker, which reduces skill cost by -25%, but it also reduces fire rate by 5%, which I really don't like. Personally, the inversion reinforcement is really not that good, and the only thing that I really like is the selective neurostimulation. Now, let's be clear, Hailey is not that good when it comes to clearing mobs. She is nothing compared to Bunny or Freyna, who can clear an entire room in mere seconds. Also, 400% invasion missions are not meant to be soloed, even though there are descendants that can solo that specific content, and to be fair, Hailey is a sniper. But when it comes to elites and commanders, that is where she shines the most. The fact that she can burst a commander pretty easily is one of the most satisfying things she can do. There are also builds that utilizes her unique weapon, Zenith, but I don't really like it simply because my playstyle is all about run and gun. Another reason why I don't like Zenith builds is that it forces you to use a lot of modules to increase one ability, and it usually ends up not being able to accommodate 2 HP modules, 2 defense modules, and HP collector, which for me are my go-to modules for survivability. I just don't feel safe when I don't have these modules. Also, Zenith builds are not that good when it comes to the latest Colossus. As of the making of this video, Deathstalker is the latest Colossus, and I don't think the Zenith build is going to work since the developers are designing the latest Colossus to take less damage from skills, and this boss requires you to move and dodge a lot of mechanics. Immobilizing yourself by using the Zenith skill is making you an easy target for the boss, and not to mention, Deathstalker is one of the unique bosses that forces you to use shield modules, which will make the Zenith build almost impossible to make. I will make another guide on shield builds, so please subscribe so you guys won't miss it. Overall, Hailey is one of my go-to descendants when it comes to void intercept battle, 400% invasion missions, and invasion missions. She is incredibly reliable when it comes to single target damage and average when it comes to AoE damage. She might not be able to beat Bunny and Freyna when it comes to AoE damage, but she definitely beats them in elites, commanders, and Colossus boss fights. As of right now, the most disappointing thing about Hailey is that she only has 2 transcendent modules, and she doesn't have a lot of skins to choose from. I don't know why the developers are doing this, and I just hope that they release the rest of her transcendent modules and skins in the future. But most importantly, the skins. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.